Hi, Otto here for Bavarian Autosport. In today's video, we're going to show you how easy it is to do a coolant flush on a typical BMW or MINI. You're going to want to do this every 2 to 3 years to keep your coolant up to specification and to protect against corrosion in your cooling system. Now, we'll be using the BMW coolant today. This will mix with distilled water. That way we can have the longest change interval of about 2 to 3 years. We also have the Evans NPG coolant. This is a waterless coolant. It's used straight at 100% strength. It's considered a lifetime coolant for most purposes. It doesn't need to be changed. We'll be using our large drain pan for coolant to catch our drainage from the block and the radiator. We'll use the garage guard mat in order to help keep any of the extra splashes outside of the pan in check and off our floor. We'll use the Forma funnel, which is a formable funnel or guide to help our drainage make it into the pan. We'll use our spill-free funnel for filling. This is unique in that it has various different adapters. This is the one we'll be using for this car. Replaces the radiator or expansion tank cap. The funnel goes right into it, and we have a leak-free application. Another unique feature is the plug in the funnel. We can fill the funnel, and if we overfill, we simply put the plug in, and we can remove the funnel from the adapter. And of course, we'll be using our Bentley repair manual. Now, today's work will be done on a 2002 X5 3-liter, but other vehicles will have different points of drain and fill. The applicable Bentley repair manual will take care of that. Now with this, let's get out to the shop and get moving on this. Now in preparation for removing the engine block drain to remove all the coolant from the engine block, first thing is, if there are any under vehicle splash shields, we have to remove those. This particular vehicle, being an X5, has an aluminum shield here and a plastic shield here. We'll remove the fasteners on both shields to drop them, and then we'll get to the engine drain. We'll remove the shields now, and then we'll come back and show you the engine drain removal. Okay, now that we have our splash shields removed, on this M54 engine, the block drain is right up on the front of the block up here. On other engines, it's often at the rear between cylinders 5 and 6 in a similar location above the oil pan. Okay, as we drain, we're going to use our Forma funnel. This is our formable basic drain assistant here to help keep the coolant from going all over the place as we drain. If the drain plug were in the rear of the block on some models, you wouldn't need the Forma funnel. So let's set up for that. We'll get the Forma funnel up, we'll get our drain pan, and then we'll remove the drain plug. Okay, now I've got the Forma funnel in place. I've loosened the drain plug. I'm going to reach up and remove the drain plug. Okay, here you are. We are draining the fluid. Did go a little bit back here too, but we've got our garage protector mat down to catch these extra drips. We caught the majority in the drain pan. And we'll just let that drip a little bit more. So this isn't all that bad. If we consider this vehicle would be on jack stands and only a couple feet off the floor, we didn't have too much area to have to worry about for the drainage. With our garage mat on the floor and the main drain pan and the Forma funnel, this did pretty good. Okay, now we've drained the block. We'll reinstall the plug in the block. The next drain from underneath before we go up top will be the radiator drain plug. This one is on the corner, right on the bottom. Some will be on the back side of the radiator side tank. Some will be over on the passenger side. Just look for the drain plug. We'll drain that from the bottom. Then we're all set to go up top. Let's do that. All right, now our final drain from underneath the car is our drain plug on the radiator. So we will take a flathead screwdriver on this. Remove the drain plug, get our drain pan right underneath. Okay, now we'll let this drain. Once it's fully drained, we will come back, return the drain plug, and then we'll go up top and perform the rest of our service. And now, we've reinstalled our drain plugs for the radiator and the engine. We're back up top. In between, what we've done is fill the system with water, run the engine until the thermostat opens with the heater on high, just the heat on high, the blower doesn't need to be running, and run the system, drain it again from both of those drain plugs. And you can do this a couple of times if you wish. Normally one time is plenty, and the idea is to get as much of the old coolant out of the system as we can. It's okay if the water is left in the system because we're going to be refilling. So right now, we've got fresh water in the system. We did the final flush with distilled water so that all that's in the system is distilled water, probably about 2 quarts or so. This is a 10-quart system. And at this point, we're going to fill with our coolant and then with more distilled water. Since it's a 10-quart system, we'll fill with 5 quarts of straight coolant and we'll do the rest with water. That'll assure that we have a 50-50 mix in the end, including the water that's in the system. So let's go, let's start filling, and we'll show you how to do that and bleed the system. Okay, now after our multiple flushes with the water, we're ready to refill the system. We'll refill right here at the cap. Most models, the cap is on your expansion tank reservoir. Some models, it's right on the radiator. We'll remove the cap. Now our bleeder for this particular model is right here. It's behind this little tag, and we can actually just remove that, set it aside so you can see the bleeder screw right here. We're also, during our first fill, going to remove the bleeder. This will allow the system to purge air as it's filling. And once we get as much coolant in as we can, we'll start the engine to continue the filling and bleeding process. Now, we're going to use our coolant funnel here with the adapter for the radiator cap. It basically seals itself right on. That way we don't have any overflow spillage. This will thread on, it's nice and tight. We put the funnel in place, and now we can fill the funnel without overflowing. We'll remove the plug for the funnel. And we'll start filling with just a 100% strength antifreeze mixture. Since there's still some water in the system from our flushing, the only way we can be sure to get a 50-50 mixture in is to add half of the complete capacity of the system in straight coolant, and then once we have that half amount of coolant in, we'll add the rest with distilled water. That'll assure us a 50-50 mixture, including the water that's already in the system. So we'll grab our BMW antifreeze, and I've already removed the inner seal, and we'll just start filling with this to begin with. And with this funnel, we can just easily empty the complete gallon in here. And the system will take it down as it can. Okay, now we'll go grab the second gallon and fill in on that. Now we've added one full gallon. The capacity on this X5 3-liter 2002 model with the M54 engine is 10 quarts. So we added 4, we're going to add 1 more quart of the straight coolant, and the bottle is marked right on the side, right over here. So it's easy just to add that 1 more quart. Take a look, a little more. And just a little bit more. Okay, so now you can see we're at the 3-quart mark, which means we've added 1 quart here. The rest we'll fill with our distilled water up until the system is full and do our final bleeding with the distilled water. So let's get to that point and we'll continue from there. All right, now we've added all of our coolant, the engine is running, and we've added most of our water up to the point where it wouldn't initially take any more. We have the engine running. The heater is on full hot. We don't especially have to have the blower on high, but the heat needs to be on full high. And we've got room for a little more water going in. And that is still going down in the funnel. We'll keep adding. We'll check that. And we'll go back and forth checking the bleeder here to see what's coming out of the bleeder. I just have this finger tight. Maybe a little tighter than finger tight. Okay, now I've got fluid coming out of the bleeder right now, just cracking it, which means there's no air at the bleeder. It's full up. There's still water in the funnel, so it's not taking any more. And we'll let this sit and watch the engine temperature. As the engine temperature comes up to normal operating temperature, we'll continue to watch if we can add more water, and we'll continue to check for air at the bleeder screw. If the engine temperature goes up to more than half, like up to 3/4, we'll shut the engine off, continue to bleed, add fluid as we can, let the temperature cool down, start it again, and keep going between bleeding, filling, and watching the temperature gauge until everything stabilizes. All right, now we've got the engine temperature up to half. It's been running that way for quite some time. We can't add any more fluid, and the bleeder is coming out with straight, clear, clean fluid and no air. So we're basically done here. Now, if we had filled the funnel over full and the expansion tank did not take all of it, what's unique here is we put the plug in like this. We can actually then, I had this cap loose, we can remove the funnel with any fluid in it. This one didn't have any. We used all the fluid in it. Remove the cap. There you can see we're very full. There's a couple of bubbles still coming out through the system, very small ones. So what we'll do here is let that just run like that a little bit, bleed itself a little more through here, then we'll put the cap on. Keep an eye on the gauge as we continue to run it. If anything else goes on, we'll open the bleeder, bleed some more air out if needed. Otherwise, we're all done here. Pretty straightforward. Now that you've seen how easy it is to do a coolant flush, why don't you get out there, take care of this operation on your BMW or MINI, and prolong its life. Remember that all of the parts that we've shown here and the tools are available at bavauto.com, or you can call our agents at 800-535-2002. If you've liked this video, please remember to hit your like button and send us some comments. Let us know what you think or if you have any questions. With that, let's get moving. It's time to make another video.